Hello guys, Mano from Geekception here, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Philips Easy BM5s. Let's begin. And welcome back guys. Now starting this review, the first thing I must actually give credit to Philips for is the build quality. Though it uses plastic, it's not cheap feeling. The buttons and dials are up top on the Philips Easy BM5s. The woofer and port are round back, and there's a rubber grip underneath the BM5s that provide grip, which I really like. Taking a tour at the buttons there, there's a play pause button which works as intended, a Bluetooth button which actually puts it in pairing mode, and a group button to group the speakers together. Because yes, this speaker, you can actually group it together. I also like the color accent underneath the dial, which you can use to control the volume there. It looks really cool. And the marquee features of the Easy BM5 is the fact that you can actually use it in a multi-room setup. But before I talk about the multi-room capabilities, let me just talk about the volume and speaker quality. Taking a look at the speaker quality, they had a high enough volume with very clear mids, and having a subwoofer did help with the bass, but there were sometimes I wish it was a bit more stronger than it was. Playing different kinds of music, I actually enjoyed the listening experience with the Easy BM5, and as usual, I did a test for you guys, so quickly check it out. Coming back from that test, do let me know what you feel of the Easy BM5s, even though this is technically not the best ideal way to test it. So setting them up for multi-room setups was a breeze, using the group button up top there, and connecting to the Easy BM5s were as easy as turning on Bluetooth on my phone and connecting, really straightforward. And after grouping all the speakers together, for me I had three, I noticed that there was a considerable lag when you play or pause or increase or decrease volume from your phone or whatever device you're connected to the Easy BM5s, and I found that disconcerting. And as usual, I did a test for you guys, so quickly check it out. Even though, yes, I do understand, Emmanuel, this is a multi-room setup, so you do not need the live immediate play. But if you planned on using this as like a kind of speaker, surround speakers in your house, then definitely not the right kind of speakers. And when it came to the multi-room setup, which is the forte of these speakers, I'd say I had no problems. It played really well. And because this is meant to be a quick video, I really hope it is. I don't know what time it's going to be. The first thing that proved for me is definitely the build quality. Even though, yes, it's made of plastic, it does not feel cheap or creaky. And another thing that I really love with the Easy BM5s were the sound quality that they produce. I would say I was really satisfied. And the most important feature, which for me takes the cake with the Easy BM5s, is the multi-room setup, which means that you can just buy one of these at a time, put it in different room from one audio source or from one Bluetooth source, and you can control everything. That is awesome. But it's not all awesome though. Because of that multi-room setup, you have to settle for that latency, and you have to be willing to understand that by the time you want to play or pause or increase or decrease the volume, there's going to be some lag there. And also the price. One of these speakers goes for about £79, which if you convert it into local Malaysian ringgit here, is about $470 just for one of them. And it can get incredibly pricey if you keep adding like three of these. It's almost £1,000, which is crazily expensive. And as I've complained earlier, I feel the bass could have been a bit more stronger. Like there were sometimes I was like, a bit more bass. And those have been my pros and cons. Now rounding up this video, I would say I love most especially the multi-room functionality. I also love the fact that you could group them together, which means that you do not have to buy everything at once. And of course, because of that huge price tag, which is something I'm really wary of. Anyways, that has been my review of the Philips Easy BM5s. I don't know, I keep messing it up in my head. Anyways, that has been my quick review. I hope this video is very quick, actually. That's my quick review of the Easy BM5s from Philips. It's been with me for such a long time now, and I've had to reshoot, and I've had some problems. But anyways, here is the video now. Hope you guys really enjoyed it. If you have any questions about the BM5s, leave a comment down there below, and I'll make sure I answer them. Don't forget to be awesome. I really, really love you guys. Give this video a big fat thumbs up if you enjoyed and like it. Thumbs up if there's anything you do not like, and do let me know in the comment down there below. And don't forget to be awesome. I shall catch you guys next time. Bye.